Networks have many pieces and parts, so it can sometimes be difficult for network professionals to visualize how a new piece of equipment or protocol fits into the overall network. Fortunately, we have a set of categories, each representing a different network function. And this set of categories is called the OSI model, where OSI stands for Open Systems Interconnection. And once we learn what sorts of things happen in each layer of this model, that's going to let us better categorize our hardware and software components and better visualize how they work together. So let's take a look at these layers one at a time, beginning with layer one, the physical layer. It's here at the physical layer where we have things like network cabling or radio waves being sent from wireless access points. And the name we give data down here at the physical layer is bits. At layer two, we have the data link layer. This layer is concerned with physical addressing. Remember our discussion about Ethernet switches and how they make decisions based on MAC address information? Well, a MAC address, that's a physical address burned into the network device. And since switches make their decisions based on those MAC addresses, we say that our Ethernet switches operate here at layer two, the data link layer. And the name we give data at layer two is frames. Moving up to layer three, we have the network layer. This layer is concerned with logical addressing, such as IP addressing. So we say that routers operate here at layer three of the OSI model. And the name we give data at this layer is packets. At layer four, the transport layer, which is concerned with logical connections. Now these connections, they might be considered reliable, where we confirm that transmitted information was received, or these connections could be considered unreliable, where we send our data and hope that it reaches its destination. And two of the main protocols that operate here at layer four are Transmission Control Protocol, or TCP for short, and User Datagram Protocol, or UDP for short. Now, TCP, that's considered to be one of those reliable transport protocols, while UDP is considered to be unreliable. And here at layer four, we call data segments. Now, the remaining layers, five through seven, they don't have any special name for data, but layer five is the session layer, and it's concerned with establishing, monitoring, and then tearing down communication sessions between our hosts. And you might hear the term APIs, and that stands for Application Programming Interfaces. And APIs let one piece of software on one device talk to another piece of software on another device. And those API sessions, they give us one example of something we might find here at layer five. Layer six is the presentation layer, and it's all about how we represent data. We might encrypt data for security reasons, so some of our encryption protocols, they live here at layer six. We might format a picture as a JPEG image. Well, that's a format of how that picture is represented, so we say JPEG formatting lives at layer six. And finally, layer seven is the application layer, and it's the layer users typically interact with. If we're surfing the web, we're using a protocol like HTTP, which stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol, or HTTPS, which is short for Secure HTTP. If we know the name of a website, but not its IP address, what we can do is ask a DNS server, and that DNS server will take the name that we provide, and it's going to give us back the IP address corresponding to that name. And the protocol that makes that possible is Domain Name System, or DNS. DNS is an example of something that lives here at layer seven. Now let's check out some memory aids to help keep all of these layers straight in our mind. We can memorize these layers from the bottom up using the acrostic, Please Do Not Throw Sausage Pizza Away, where the P in please reminds us of the P in physical, the D in don't reminds us of the D in data link, and so on. Alternately, we can go from the top down. We can memorize all people seem to need data processing. And the names that we gave our data at the bottom four layers, those names are called protocol data units, or PDUs. And a way to remember those different protocol data unit names from the bottom up is to remember the acrostic bacon frying produces salivation, which is standing for bits, frames, packets, and segments. And the best advice I've ever heard about the OSI model is to remember, it's a reference model, it's not a reverence model. It doesn't have to be revered as something that every network component must neatly fit into. That's just not reality. However, this model can be a tool we can use to better explain and understand where different network components reside.